Blog Talk Radio.
We're living in a time where everybody is struggling for their lives. They're stressed, they're depressed. But with the power invested in me, I came to speak life over you. I speak blessings of health, blessings of peace. To my brothers and sisters all around the world, especially those in South Africa, struggling with AIDS, in Brazil, the States.
I speak life, you're gonna live. Oh, my brother, my sister, I speak life, you are the head and not the tail, you will prevail. I speak life. Don't give up the fight for your life. You shall live and not die.
Let's not lose another person to a senseless death. Substance abuse, gang violence, suicide because of low self-esteem. The power of life and death is in the tongue. Speak life over yourself and those you love.
Help me sing it.
I speak life, you're gonna live. Oh, my brother,
say it again.
I speak life, you are the head and not the tail. You will prevail.
Good morning. Good glorious Sunday morning. How blessed we are. We're still yet in the land of the living, and we are truly, truly blessed this morning. I welcome each and every one of you to the Spiritual View this morning. I'm your host, Bishop Addie Robb, and what a pleasure it is for me to come before you this morning, praising and worshiping God, knowing that He is the great I Am, the wonderful one, the glorious one, the victorious one in our lives. First of all, I'd like to thank all of the people that came to help me as God placed a vision and a mission in my heart to send barrels to Africa, to Lagos, Africa, to Apostle Jesse in Lagos. I thank God for that because God is so overwhelming. There were so many things that people gave us and that were brought for the people in Africa until we ended up not sending two barrels, but we had to purchase another barrel. And so God is an awesome God. And when we do things God's way and we walk in His will, God provides. I want you to know that this morning, that when your vision is God's vision, that God provides. Hallelujah. And I'm grateful. I'm thankful for Dr. Doris Dorsey, Mina Avery, Margaret Winkler, Carol Ridgely, Ruthie Johnson, my brother John Parker, everyone that contributed to the barrels. The names go on and on, Pastor Dillard. The names go on, and I'm so grateful this morning. The barrels have been sent. We've packed them all, and we thank FEMA for also our shipper, for also being so kind to us. We just praise God this morning. I want you to know that if you've been knocked down, that you can get up. They got up, and we too can get up. If we look at the different men and women in the Bible who got knocked down through a variety of circumstances and ended up being greatly blessed by God because they got up. They were people just like us who ran into some heartache and disappointments in life, but they got back up. I want you to know that you don't have to stay down because you've been knocked down, but that you can and should get back up. Let us look at a woman by the name of Hannah. Hannah's name means grace. She had captured the heart of Elkanah and knew that he wanted her to be his wife. She was so excited about the marriage and the many children they would have. Her future looked so promising. No doubt, they had a wonderful wedding ceremony in the joining of their families. They began their lives together, and they truly loved each other. It all started out so well. The problem started about a year in the marriage when people started asking, when is that little boy going to start coming along? She would joke with the women and say, oh, we're working on it. They kept working on it, but there was no pregnancy. Hannah started feeling downcast and depressed. Why isn't she getting pregnant? Now, you have to understand that at this time in history and in some cultures today, the pressure on a young woman to produce not only a child, but even more so a son was enormous. It was proof of God's blessing on their relationship. So Hannah was knocked down. But she did get up. I want you to read 1 Samuel 1, 1 through 1 and 28, and find encouragement in the story of this woman's life. Hannah mingled tears with her prayers. She considered the mercy of God, who knows the troubled heart. God gives us leave in prayer, not only to ask good things in general, but to mention that special good thing we most need and desire. She spoke softly. None could hear her. She testified her belief of God's knowledge of the heart and its desires. Eli was high priest and judge in Israel. It becomes to us not to be rash and hasty in our judgment of others and to think people guilty of bad things while the matter is doubtful and unproved. Eli believed that this woman, Hannah, was drunk. Hannah did not retort the charge, and she did not talk to Eli with wicked words or showed wicked conduct, because she knew of the conduct of his sons and how they were sinning against God. When we are at any time unjustly judged, we have need to set a double watch before the door of our lips. When we are judged by other people because we're going through, because we have been knocked down, we need to guard our lips, that we do not return judgment for judgment. Hannah thought it enough to clear herself, and so must we. Eli was willing to acknowledge his mistake. Hannah went away with satisfaction of mind. She had herself, by prayer, committed her case to God, and Eli had prayed for her. Prayer is heart's ease to a gracious soul. Prayer will smooth the continents. It should do so. None will long remain miserable who use upright the privilege of going to the mercy seat of a reconciled God in Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, we thank you this morning that we can go directly to God when we've been knocked down. Everybody, each and every one of us have been pushed down a couple of times in life by something or by someone. We grow up and there is a bully pushing us down. We have circumstances that come in our lives that we have no control over, and they knock us down. We didn't see the illness or the disease coming that would knock us down. We couldn't see the divorce or separation on the horizon, even though we were having problems, so it knocked us down. We certainly didn't expect to lose our jobs when we were doing such a good job for the company, so it knocked us down. We didn't expect the bills to overwhelm us day after day when we would go to our mailboxes. It was one deal after the other, and we had no money to pay, so it knocked us down. We had no idea that one stupid choice we made was going to put us in the situation we found ourselves in. But what thing really, that thing really knocked us down? There is something that is here now, or something that is coming in the future that is going to knock us down. And there's nothing we can do to make sure our lives are free from knockdowns. It doesn't really matter if you are knocked down. The most important thing is that you get back up. Today we're going to ask God to give us the strength and the courage to get back up. No matter how many times we've been knocked down, we have to understand that we can get back up. So many times people have asked me to pray for them, and even after the prayer, they're not convinced that God will intercede on their behalf. They go to somebody else, and they ask them to pray the prayer of faith. They run to prophets, and they ask them to see what God is going to do. We have to be people that are convinced that if we're knocked down, that we can get back up. We have to know in our heart, and we have to walk in faith, that no matter what has come into our life to kill, steal, or destroy, that we as people, as children of God, can and should get back up. I want you to get there with me today. I don't want you to continue to cry, continue to be miserable, continue to be full of doubt, but know that God, the God of your salvation, the God, hallelujah, that breathed the breath of life in you this morning, is the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. He's the same God that's holding your hand. He's the same Alpha and Omega. He's the same Jehovah Jireh, your provider. He's the same God, hallelujah. He is, hallelujah, Jehovah Nisi, your protector. Don't you understand this morning that no matter what's going on in your life, that God is your all in all, that you can call on him day or night, and he shall, hallelujah, he shall deliver you. I want you to wipe away the tears this morning and begin to praise and worship God. There is a saying that when the praise go up, hallelujah, the blessings come down. Not when the tears go up, but when the praise, hallelujah, hallelujah, when the praise go up, hallelujah, the blessings come down. We want to be blessed children, blessed people of God. And in order to have the blessings of God, we need to praise him, whether we have money or not. We need to praise him in our sickness, hallelujah. We need to praise him if we've lost our jobs. We need to continue to praise God because he is the answer, hallelujah, to every problem and every situation. Let us go to the throne of grace and mercy this morning, knowing that God shall rise us up out of our muck and our mire. God shall pull us out of our pits. He shall stand us, hallelujah, on solid ground. I know you're feeling it today because I'm feeling it as well, because I know that no matter what my problems are, that God, hallelujah, shall bring me out. I know, hallelujah, for he's done it so many times in the past, and he's the same God. He's the same God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's the same God, hallelujah, that parted the Red Sea for Moses. He's the same God that was with Joseph in the prison, hallelujah, down in the dungeon. And he's the same God that rose him as the governor of a foreign land. He's the same God, hallelujah, that brought the children out of Egypt. He's the same God. He's the same God. And I'm telling you this morning that he's the same God that shall deliver you, that you can and should get back up, that you shouldn't stay down, that you should not continue, hallelujah, to be in misery, that you should not continue, hallelujah, to wonder what God is doing in your life, but that you should get back up. We thank God this morning for being the God that he is. We thank God this morning for being wonderful and awesome, for being a God of deliverance, for being a glorious and wonderful God. Let us go to the throne of grace and mercy this morning. Heavenly Father, glorious Father, merciful Father, we've made some mistakes, and we've been knocked down. Sometimes people have come in our life, and by what they've done or said, we have found ourselves flat on our back. We were knocked down. However, this morning, we're learning from Hannah what we must do when we're knocked down. We're asking this morning, as we pray the prayer of faith, as we seek your face, as we believe with all our heart, and as we wait on you, we are convinced that we can and will get back up, for you will uphold us with your right hand of righteousness. Oh, Heavenly Father, we are assured by the word this morning that you want us to be successful, for you are not a man that you should lie. We're standing on the promises, the covenant promises that have been given us. Thank you, Lord, for we are blessed in heavenly places. Thank you, Lord, for leading and guiding us. Thank you, Lord, for delivering us. Thank you, Lord, for all of your mercies and your grace. For your grace is sufficient for us, and this we know. We thank you, Lord, this morning for family and friends. Father, we thank you, hallelujah, for not only being our deliverer, for not only being our healer, for not only, hallelujah, holding us up and making us new creations in Christ Jesus, but for blessing our children and our children's children. Father, we thank you, hallelujah, for touching their lives this morning. Father, we thank you, hallelujah, for placing a wedge of protection around them that no hurt, harm, or danger comes near them. Oh, Lord, hallelujah, how merciful you are. How kind you are. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, 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 hallelujah. Oh, we praise you this morning. We honor you this morning. And Father, we bless your name today. We thank you, hallelujah, that you, hallelujah, have shined a light on us today. Oh, Hashanta, Hariabakaka Hasanda. Hey, Hariabahashanda. Oh, Father, you are glorious and victorious in our life. And we are a victorious people. We're strong and we're bold. And Father, as we come to this throne of grace and mercy, Father, we're giving you every problem, every situation, knowing with full confidence that you shall work it out in our life. Every tear has been dried today. And Father, we stand on your covenant promises. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. God has delivered you. God has delivered you. He's working behind the scenes to bring you to a new place. Stop crying. Stop being sorrowful. Stop walking with your head down, but look to the hills from whence cometh your help. Your help cometh from God Almighty. You are strong, you're bold, you are victorious, and you shall overcome. I'm telling you this morning, I'm speaking a word of faith into your life that you too shall overcome in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you this morning for being such loyal people, coming on to the spiritual view. I thank you for your love and support. I thank you for all that you've done for Women Uplifting Women Ministries as we reach out across the world to provide provisions for the widows and orphans, not only in Africa, but here in the United States as well. We have our own problems and we have our own issues, and so many in this country is without. But God has given us a vision. He's given us a mission to help out where we can. And we thank God this morning for all the support he's given to us. May you be blessed today. Walk in your vision. Walk in your mission. No matter what is going on in your life, don't give up on God, for God has not given up on you. Have a blessed and a blessed and a blessed Sunday and the rest of the week. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
We're living in a time where everybody is struggling for their lives. They're stressed. They're depressed. But with the power invested in me, I came to speak life over you. I speak blessings of health, blessings of peace. To my brothers and sisters all around the world, especially those in South Africa, struggling with AIDS, in Brazil, the States.
I speak life, you're gonna live. Oh, my brother, my sister, I speak life.
Get back up, get back up, in the name of Jesus. Get back up. You can and you should get back up. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, hallelujah, for strengthening us this day. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, hallelujah, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. We thank you, hallelujah, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus.